welcome to the channel. It's your boy that kid Trey, and today for you got us some Ravens theme team, and we gonna show you what I got. It's 46 out of 50. Before we get into that, I would like to thank these subscribers: Logan Lynn, Caleb Terry, and Altered Vision TV. Thanks for commenting on my videos and being subscribers. If you want me to mention you in the video, you know, subscribe and comment. So right here we got an 87 defense, 85 offense, 86 overall in total. The offense, you know, it's been doing well. I've been getting good dots using my new formation. Did drop a video on that today. Check it out if you want to. And, you know, we've been passing for some good yards. Been grinding. We got, you know, the backup RG3. Was the Lamar before the Lamar. If he didn't get hurt, he would probably be, you know, starting quarterback somewhere. Probably still at the Redskins, well, the Washington football team. But, you know, we just out here filling in spots. As you see, those silvers and golds are very important. The Ravens do not have a backup left tackle in the game yet. So it's just, you know, Robert Stanley right there. And they don't have, like, a good right guard. So we just don't have to fill in. That's probably one of those Eagles players. But wide receivers, you're pretty strong right now. Andre Johnson, Willie Snead. I mean, Hollywood Brown, he just fumbles too much. Like, hit sticking is so easy in this game to the point where, like, I don't even put him in the game because a gold card is just getting destroyed every time. Throw a slant, just get hit stick by Sam Mills and fumble. But 10 out of 10 AP, we got some nice abilities on the team. Slot-O-Matic, route technician, dashing dead eye on Lamar. And the little stuff. We've been trying out some new abilities, and I'll let you know if I find anything game-breaking. Besides that, you know, offense is really the same. The Ravens don't really have any major changes. I don't have Mark Andrews. I just have his gold card right now, but I really don't pass to a tight end anyway. But it's more or less just filling in spots. Because, you know, I got majority everybody, except for, like, the punter, Mark Andrews, and some others. But those are my abilities. I've been trying to use a new lineman ability, but it don't work. Like, edge, no edge protector fool me once. Is I guess it helps, but if you want to use that, put it on the guard. I know it works great on guards very well, but defense, that's where we made a lot happen, man. We made a lot happen. As you can see, it's some new faces on the defense. Marcus Peters, this man is a god, bro. 90 man coverage on him. He got like 92 speed on the theme team, 92 excel, 91 agility. Look at that man coverage, 90 man, bro. He is shutting down a lot of receivers. Tyreek Hill is not just, you know, cutting them up. He might not be the best, you know, corner in the game, but dude, this guy right here is probably the best investment. His car was only 90k. I'm talking about the market went down, got it for 90k. We got bench press on him, because why not? But that ability chuck out, I'm gonna tell y'all something, the ability chuck out is the same thing as bench press, but it's for zone. They're not telling you this, but it's the exact same thing as bench press, but it's for zone. I'm putting it on Rod Woodson, and I'm going to start testing it out, because if you look at what it says, it's the exact thing as bench press, but for zone. But Deion Sanders, we don't have him fully maxed out, but like 90 speed, 91 excel, 91 agility, and he's good. He's a good car. He really depends on his speed a lot, because, you know, he does have good man coverage, but hey, manning him up on a tight end is good. I use it for my slot, but Roy Woodson, the newest, you know, he was on the team, but full power dude on the team. And he got chuck out on him. Like I'm telling you, it says zone chucks, fatigues the receiver. And look at bench press. Press wins, fatigue the receiver. It's basically the exact same thing, but for zone. Y'all, I'm telling y'all, I'm putting you on, bro. Especially if you run zone a lot like me, it's gonna be nice. A card I haven't shown yet is, you know, Leroy Glover. He's a great force in the middle. And, you know, he does his job, but, you know, the Ravens need to drop some better cards in that spot. You know, left end, we got Doomerville. Probably best, you know, not a left end, but best edge threat guy in the game, in my opinion. Because that speed and 90 XL off the edge is just crazy, bro. Those left tackles can catch up with him. But it's like little things that I need to put on the team. Like Marlon Humphreys, he's good, but he's not anything amazing. 88 speed, not as good, but 78 zone. He got good press. I mean, it's great press for a 87. Well, he's 86. 87 with Team Kim, but he's nothing worth, you know, going out your way. You might as well get Dion and just pay the training for him. He better than that. But, you know, the team is really better than last time. And Calais Campbell, he is a D tackle. I'm going to pay the extra training. Like, next time y'all see this video, he's going to be a D tackle. And Adalius Thomas is going to be a right end. Or Za'Darius Smith, because Za'Darius Smith, that boy got 89. I think power move, and it's great. He be getting in the backfield, but Calais Campbell, he's too slow, bro. I had a run stopper on him. He'll get in the backfield and just watch. He'll just watch Reggie Bush just run 30 yards down the field. It's not worth it putting on him. Adalius Thomas, I want to power him up, but at the same time, it's like. I don't use them that much, because the way I use, like, most of the time, I just have Doomerville off the edge, and my other end, I'll put, like, a fast guy and zone him. That's how I run my defense, but I only use, like, one DN, really. But Za'Darius Smith, that 89 power move is very intriguing to me, like, and he's 6'4". So I'm like, if I put him at end, if I put Za'Darius Smith at end, right in, Calais Campbell in the middle, then my big nickel is going to be complete, bro. Because I run big nickel. If you want me to drop a video, well, I have a video on that. It's a video of me doing big nickel, you know, in my YouTube channel. But I run big nickel a lot, so for them four down linemen are very important. We got Terrell Edmonds right there. And that's just more or less because they don't have a good strong safety. They have Clark, but I'm not putting no goal with that strong safety. That's like, for me and my defense, that's like one of the most important positions on my field. And my abilities, I'm running chuck out, which is bench press, but for zone. And I'm running bench press, edge track, and etc. So I've been trying to figure out like what other abilities to put on my players. And if you got anything, please let me know, because my defense literally needs help with abilities. Like, I'm thinking about putting like enforcer and secure tackler and stone wall on Eric Weddle, but at the same time I'm like, should I put this on my D line or just like have my cornerback stacked out, or what? I don't know. Let me know in the comments. But we got the main man, Justin Tucker. This dude is probably one of my favorite kickers in the league. And he wasn't cheap, but hey, we don't worry about that. We just get the Kim. Right here I'm running, you know, for offense, Las Vegas Raiders, 4-6 defense. And I know you see the Bucks unis over there. But listen, man. I'm just waiting for them to drop the Ravens color rush jerseys. I do not like the half purple and white. It just, in real life, it looks good, but in the game, I don't really like it. So we just gonna wait on that. But thanks for watching the video. Check out some other videos. And if you want to have have your channel shouted out, hey, just subscribe and comment. Peace, brother.